long time no speak in this kind of getup. You guys have seen me kind of casualed up, but for once I'm properly dressed like Mars, Agajo, here we go. Yeah. So I thought we'd do kind of a Gyaru makeup haul, clothing haul, because we haven't done one in a while, and I thought it'd be kind of fun to do because I always enjoy other people's hauls. But before we get started on that, I have a huge announcement to make. Saturday, April 8th, between 1:30 and 2 p.m., pretty sure, in San Francisco, Japantown, Sakura 360, or the Cherry Blossom Festival, will be occurring, and I will be modeling for it yet again, but instead of doing Gyaru fashion, I know a lot of people are going to be like, oh my god, you traitor, but I will be modeling for the Lolita fashion show, meaning Lolita stuff will be on me for the first time in 3 years, and I am so excited. I basically am working with some amazing people who like reached out to me. Thank you very, very much. Like, I'm super flattered. And I'm going to be wearing a style that I've never worn before. And on top of that, it's going to be like a huge challenge. Not only that, but I'm, like I said, this is the first time I've worn Lolita in 3 years. So this is very, very exciting. And if you're in the area, you should totally come and support. It's going to be a really fun time. I'm sure there are other great Lolitas that are going to be in this show. I'm just kind of here doing my thing. I don't know Lolita really, so we'll see how that goes. So I'm going to start off with makeup because it's like right in front of me, and we'll get into clothing in just a second. So I did a little bit of shopping, and the first thing I got was from Target. I am with a shampoo order and some makeup wipe orders. Like, I got makeup wipes, but I don't think this is a huge part of my haul. Personally, I like using the Daiso makeup wipes, but I ran out of them, and I don't live near a Daiso, so yeah, I got some Elf ones because they're the next best thing. But I like Daiso ones, but I'm like an hour and a half away from San Francisco to get to a Daiso. So yeah, I got some Elf makeup wipes, some shampoo, some necessity stuff. But I also got the NYX Pore Filling Primer, and people compare this to the Benefit Professional. The texture's it's silicone-y, but it, like, you can feel it filling in the holes in your face, at least for me. I honestly like it better than the Baby Skin. The Baby Skin's very oily. The only one that kind of beats this one is the Tarte Poreless Clean Slate Primer, but this is a good alternative. Though for $13, it's a really tiny bottle. Moving on, I was a bad girl. Oh my god, guys. I don't know what to get into first, but I think I'm going to get into the Sephora order, because the Sephora order was insane. Like, insane. So I pretty much went on Sephora and was kind of like, treat yourself. Like, really treat yourself. I had to buy a concealer anyway. Had to hit shipping anyway. I had to buy a makeup brush cleaner, and so I decided, to get some things. The first thing, I'll just get into the necessities first. How about that? The first thing I did is I got a refill of the NARS Creamy Radiant Concealer. This is my go-to concealer. I wear it in the color Chant Lily. A lot of girls use this as a highlight on their face. Personally, it is the color of my skin. Like, even, where is it? This foundation, Mont Blanc, oxidizes all my skin. Like, it's, there's a little bit of discoloration, like, not matching, but this is literally the palest shade. But this concealer is literally my shade. Like, they need to just make a foundation in this shade because it's my shade. But yeah, I like this. It doesn't go into fine lines and wrinkles. It covers really, really well. A little goes a long way. Actually, this is the same tube I've been using. I haven't hit the second one yet, but I was afraid not to get this because, yeah, necessities. The next thing I got was the Cinema Secrets Makeup Brush Cleaner. This is like my holy grail right now. This is what has been keeping my face sanitary. Beforehand, I was just using like the home method of, you know, cleaning your makeup brushes. But this stuff like makes your brushes, I'm not even shitting you guys, this stuff makes your makeup brushes look like what they did when you first bought them. Like, they get rid of everything. Everything. Like, I'm not even kidding. Like, even foundation, they get rid of everything. It's pretty amazing. I had a really small bottle. Where's my small bottle? This is my, this is like the $24 one, and then I just decided to get the value size one, because, that's quite a difference. This is 24, this is 32, so I just busted the $32 for this one, because this is gonna last me a long while because I didn't realize that I'd like it that much, so that's what I ended up doing. And here's where I was a bad girl. Like, I was so bad. Can you not? Like, oh my god, Garla. So I got the Anastasia Modern Renaissance palette. You guys have seen me use this in a tutorial already, but oh, this palette. Like, I cannot with this palette. This palette is amazing. I think every girl needs this palette. Like, if you love red eyeshadows, if you like to work with mattes and satins, this is your shit. Like, this is such a good palette. Like, can you see? Like, I've already, like, dug in there so much. It's so pigmented. A little just goes so, like, such a long way with this. I'm almost afraid to travel with this because this is so creamy and so great. I know a lot of people don't like the packaging because it's, like, this velvet material, but honestly, I keep it in the box and this keeps it clean. Like I said, I've just been on Anastasia Beverly Hills Fix lately, and this has been a favorite product of mine. This is palette. Best $42 investment ever. Like, points? Yeah. So, the next thing I bought, I was like a super bad girl after that, because Sugar Pill was having a 50% off sale. Like, they pulled out all the stops. Like, they had the Feline Fancy palette, but I didn't get it because it reminded me too much of the Etude House Berry Delicious Collection palette, kind of like in the same hue range, not exactly in terms of pigmentation. And the thing is I wanted Strange Love really bad, but they weren't selling it separately. So yeah, I didn't end up getting that, but then they had a 50% off to like 70% off sale. And I saw some really good things, so I hopped on that. So the first things I ended up getting from Sugar Pill were these two eyelashes. I think they were like $3. I'm definitely gonna probably wear one of these for like Sakura 360. I'm pretty sure it's gonna be this pair. It might, yeah, it's gonna be this pair. This is this is Crystalline and this is Idol. They have like jewels on the eyelashes and they're just so pretty. I'm so thrilled and so excited to use this. If you hear noises, that is my squeaky ass chair. Sorry about that, guys. And the next thing I ended up buying from Sugar Pill was Penelope, because Penelope is one of those shades that I've wanted for a while and it's always been out of stock every time I try to look for it and buy it along with Asylum, so I just got it. And this is like the color. It's so beautiful. I'm just going to like swatch this from like the canister because I'm so afraid to like, I'm trying to do like photo shoot stuff later, but it's gorgeous. It's such a pretty copper, like I can't get over it. Like, yes. So that happened. And then I also ended up buying, since Mama was on a roll today. Well, not on a roll, but like I was when I was shopping for some Sugar Pill. And I was just like, I like trinkets so much that I'm going to buy kimchi. So I ended up buying kimchi, you know, kind of also to make up for the fact that I couldn't buy Strange Love. This is a really pretty purple, like, liquid lipstick. Oh my god, I can't talk today. And I really, really like it. Like, I have a couple purple liquid lipsticks. This one, for instance, but they're kind of different. And then I have another one that I can't. It's like a fake lime crime, and it's a purple, but it's definitely more plummy. These are all my, like, purple-hued liquid lipsticks, but, kimchi obviously feels a lot better. You know, I just like Sugar Pill's liquid lipstick formula. They should make like a million more colors because I'd probably buy them all. Okay, so here's the last thing from Sugar Pill, and it's a big one. Like, this is, when I saw this for $25, I could not, like, I had to have them in my life. And that was the Sugar Pill Electrocutes pigments, which are like super glittery, super neon, like, kill me now, guys. And these originally, like, even on the website right now, they retail for $65 for a set, and I got them for $25 because I'm awesome like that. So I definitely snagged at those while those were a thing. I'm just gonna open one just to kind of show you guys like how sparkly and beautiful they are. You probably can't tell because my lighting sucks, but like it's just beautiful. Like the color of these is just, I'm gonna do like one little and pray to God that it doesn't go on my Mars dress. Please, Lord Jesus. Like, save me. That or slay me, I don't know. Let me see. I should use a brush. I really should. Okay, yeah, here we go. So I'm just gonna quickly swatch this on my arm. It's beautiful. Beautiful, beautiful. Like, this is such a nice color. This one has, like, purple glitter in it. I don't think, like, I'm trying to put it near the light. I'm trying to do things. One day we're gonna get a better camera, guys. I'll probably do a separate video on these, actually. Probably. Most likely. Because they're just so nice, and I think everybody needs to have these at least once in their life. You gotta play with color. I am actually wearing... Where is it? What is this one called? This one's called Love Buzz, and I'm actually wearing it today with my Agajo look, and it just looks good. It just looks nice with this, and I'm actually wearing it on the center of my lips even too. So yeah, that was a thing. That's something that I've just been thoroughly enjoying. Today I think was the first time I used the Electrocutes even. That's how good those were. Afterward, I did a slight Korean beauty haul, and I decided to, first off, hold on, I'm trying to, like, clean up here, stock up on some things that I have been needing for a while, which was the Holika Holika Magic Pearl Mascara. You guys have heard me rant and rave about this mascara. It's the best. I think they compare it to the Benefit Their Real, and I've also seen it compared to the Majorica Lash Master, but this is like $9 and even $8. I've seen it for like $7 and $8 even, so it's a very cheap fix for a mascara, especially if you wear like false eyelashes like I do. Like, that's a thing. Afterward, I went on a lip tint like craze. For a second there, I was really, 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 really disliking gradient lips. Like, I had watched the Korean movie The Handmaiden, and one of the actresses in there had like gorgeous lips, like lip tints, and at that time the Etude House Wonder Fun Park collection I think was out, so I ended up buying the Dear My Darling lip tints. This one is, I'm not sure what, PP501, and this one is orange 201, so like purple pink and orange. This one has glitter in it, this one doesn't. Once they fade away, they leave a really pretty stain on your lips. Obviously I can't wear it today because I have lipstick on. But this is one of the few things that was actually decent from the Wonder Fun Park line. I heard the Wonder Fun Park line was kind of a bust, but supposedly the lip tints were decent, so that's a salvageable thing. I'm glad I didn't like bust a ton of money on this. However, this one is the Vampire Red. It's BK801. I also got this lip tint because this thing is like a purple red, like so dark vamp red. I needed it, like, because sometimes you just don't want to deal with a vamp red lipstick that's gonna go everywhere. So I thought about getting this. It's really messy, and I haven't figured out how they exactly use it yet because it separates and it does things. But I want to play with it more. The color is really pretty. I think it's just the fact that the application is rather difficult. Not sure, you tell me, somebody show me how to use this stuff properly. Okay, so the last thing I got that was like makeup related was these Diamond Lash eyelashes. I'm wearing them today. I have the old ones, like the ones that were made like a little later on. This is what they look like. You probably really can't tell on camera, not on my webcam at least. But these are the Angel Eye series in the new packaging. Absolutely gorgeous, very, very voluminous, very comfortable to use. The band on these are a little thinner than the old packagings, I will just say that right now. But other than that, they're great. Like, I really, really like them. So yeah, that is the makeup haul. Now we're going to get on to the clothing haul. So hi guys, forgive me for changing my film setup. I started realizing that I just really didn't have enough room to be able to film in that area and show you guys the clothes properly. So please forgive the lighting. I don't have a ring light or anything, so we're just making do with what we have and filming in this space. So I'm getting on to my clothing haul now. I had a very, very generous friend give me the majority of these, say for two pieces, so yeah, thank you, you know who you are. My friend was basically like, yeah, you're probably going to make more use out of these than I am, I'm just gonna throw them in your direction. So I received a package with a bunch of cute shit. Starting off with this really, really adorable, really, really cute Samantha Vega handbag. You guys know that I have like a couple like fake Sailor Moon Samantha Vegas, but nothing really compares to like the real. There's such a weight on the hardware, like the chain. This has like diamonds, like little jewels in there, and they like sparkle in the light, though I'm pretty sure you can't really tell on this. It's got a really nice little heart enclosure, and when you open up the bag, this is what it looks like inside. Now, don't mind me, I have a car charger in here, but very, very cute, very, very versatile. You can make it a shoulder or a handbag thanks to the chain. Yeah, it's great. So yeah, that's the first thing I got. The next thing I got actually grew on me. I didn't think that I'd like this piece, but then I ended up liking it a lot, like a lot. And it's this d.i.a. jacket. It probably should show you the back first. The back is like this. It's got English, and it kind of reminds me of like Chrome Hearts for some reason. It says Palmer Power Courage. You turn to the route. I live in pursuit of you. Two, let's grow cool together. So weird. And then it says like Power Courage on like the sleeves. And it's one of those like jacket dresses, but it doesn't work on me because I'm a busty girl. But it does have like gathered sleeves, and I have worn this like to go out and be kind of casual, like Starbucks runs and that type of thing. So yeah, that was fun to have. After that, I was given a very, very cute Liz Lisa top. Pretty sure it's from an older collection. This is a pink top with sheer material lining down at the bottom. Like so. Really, really cute buttons. Here's the back. It has like a keyhole little area in the back. Suede or velvet in here with just a little bit of crochet lace. Very, very cute to wear with jeans or just other things. I'm gonna see if I can find a pair of shorts to even go with this, maybe, or a skirt. Not exactly sure yet, but it's very, very cute, and I really, really, really like it. You know, who can say no to a bunch of clothes, Lisa? So, the next top I got was this top, and this is another Liz Lisa top. Kind of reminds me of that very famous, like, runway dress that they had. I'm very curious to see if there's a skirt with this. So far, I've looked in a couple of different places, and I can't find a skirt to this. Unfortunately, I have too much boob for it, I think, so right now it's really not wanting to zip up on me, but I'm also realizing my Marge dress is kind of the same way and it used to not be, so time for a bitch to lose weight, probably, and this will probably fit me just fine. But yes, very, very cute. I really, really like it. Yeah, yet again, good put with boobs, at the least. The next thing I ended up getting was another surprising piece from d.i.a. out of all things. Excuse the fact that it's like falling off the hanger because everything likes to fall off the hangers. It's got such a pretty pattern. I've actually worn this on my social media already. It's got like a really like nice purple pink floral print pattern. Ruffles over here. It's very onné in my opinion. It's got like crochet like see-through sleeves. Very, very good for spring. Lined even. I think this is supposed to be a tunic dress. I wore it with jeans and it kind of made me look bigger than what I really was. I feel like I need a belt to cinch the waist, but I have a belt that kind of matches, but it's loose on me, so I don't know what to do about that. But yeah, I'll probably try wearing this again. This has worked really well within the Anastasia Beverly Hills Modern Renaissance palette. I've been wearing like the little dusty purple color with the Etude House Berry Delicious collections, like little pink matte color, and it just looks really nice. I'm probably gonna add like mint green eyeliner because there's like little hints of green in this. I don't know if you can tell, but it's there. So yes, very nice piece from d.i.a. Unexpectedly from d.i.a. And then I think I have like one more piece that I had, and it's like my favorite piece out of all pieces that I got from my friend. Like, it was beautiful, and for some reason the little piece that I need to fix came off, so I must look for it. But this is a gold infinity top, and it is so nice. There's like a little dangle that has came off into my floor somewhere, so I have to go hunt for that. But there's like the brooch and there is a dangle piece. I have to like make like a like solder it together so that way it'll stay on. But it's got really, really nice like lace sleeves.
It's very off the shoulder. It's got like little studs in there. Surprisingly not the little typical diamond detail that usually they put at the straps, but that's fine. You know, it makes up for it with everything else. The sleeves are kind of in that like vampire-y triangle type of shape. I don't know how to explain it. I'm gonna have to like wear this and try it out. Probably gonna put like a pencil skirt with this because it's one of those dresses where I feel like that would, not dress, but one of those tops that I feel like goes really well, because I tried to put like a fluffy skirt under it and it just didn't work, so pencil skirt it is for this one. So afterward, I spoiled the shit out of myself. I used a shopping service for the first time in a little while, and I saw some Mars pieces that I really, really wanted. Like, these pieces were like calling out to me, and I kind of wanted to be a trendy bitch for once, because I'm always kind of, I've been behind for a while. Like, I'm always buying older stuff, which, I mean, I have an appreciation for the older stuff, definitely, but sometimes I'm like, man, I kind of want to be on trend. So that's what I did. So the first thing I got was this Mars sweater, and it's the like trendy little keyhole sweater. I've worn this before in another video of mine. Well, not a video, but I've worn it on social media already. Some of you guys know what this looks like on me, but I haven't really like went all out with it. But it's very cute. It's like open chest, but then you have like all this beading and like jewels around it, making it very, very ladylike. It's short sleeve, which is good for winter or spring in my opinion. I wish I could put like a belt around the waist because I feel like that would be really nice. It's been very, very comfortable. Like, I wore this to go out to eat with my family, and just no problems at all. So yeah, the only thing I'm very, very nervous about with this sweater, because I'm already kind of like seeing like threads and stuff, that's the only thing that's making me really nervous, because I know, I think once I put this in the washer, it's gonna be a problem. I'm really gonna have to either get a laundry bag or reinforce the beads and the jewels with some more thread, which is gonna take a while. So that's the thing. The last dress I got was from a brand that I've actually never bought from before, but I saw it on Himena Osaki, and I pretty much just had to have it. Like, I needed it in my life. Like, I wanted a really elegant princessy dress, especially since I got a Mars dress back in like September that was supposed to be my birthday dress, and it didn't end up fitting me, unfortunately. I have too much of a chest right now, too much of just everything right now. Like I said, I'm gonna have to go on a diet. Like, either, like, I know like everybody's like, go on a diet before COD, but it's probably gonna be after COD, let's be honest, because a girl just likes to eat, especially when she's deprived of nice things in her area usually. So yeah, I ended up getting a back on topic. I ended up getting a Princess Melody dress, and this is so pretty, and it fits me so freaking well, like, because it's got shirring and whatnot, and I just bought a waist belt for it that I'm probably gonna like put jewels on, so it'll kind of look like the belt that's supposed to go with it that I couldn't justify paying $30 to $50 for, like, because it's a waist belt, for God's sake. So yeah, I just ended up getting the dress. This dress was originally like $140, and I got it for $60, which is nice. It's got like shoes on it, so I kind of call it like the Cinderella dress. And what really like got me about this dress was the sleeves, because they're so princessy. Like, they have like, they're like gathered here, and then they're gathered here, and they kind of layer up, so they're kind of drapey and nice. And I really do like the, whatchamacallit, the lace at the bust, and it's like see-through. So I think I'm going to wear this the Friday I go to Fanime. I was really tempted to wear this to Sakura 360 until I figured out like I gotta wear Lolita. This was what I was going to like wear to Z Fashion Show and put like a fluffy skirt under it and make it like very Hime Gyaru. But since I'm limited to Lolita, I have another outfit ready for that, but I'm definitely going to wear this to Fanime and do my hair up better than what it is now. Like, literally my hair is like falling apart, which is really disappointing. But yeah, that's the last dress in this haul, meaning this haul is basically over. Thank you guys so much for watching this very long video full of announcements, makeup, and clothes. Hopefully I'll have some more videos ready and done in the near future. Until next time, guys. Bye-bye.